Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back for our daily devotional. Can you believe it's been 1 week? That's pretty amazing. Today is January 25th, and my topic is my personal pathway. The scripture that we have, as you see on the daily devotional, is probably, honestly, one of my favorite scriptures. Matthew 22:27. You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind. That pretty much sums it up. And then, of course, the following verse, which we don't have listed here, which if we do this verse right, then it's easy for the next verse, which is, and to love your neighbor as yourself. When I was reflecting on this and praying about what to say for this particular day, for me, my biggest roadblock in receiving this verse about loving the Lord God with all my heart and soul and mind is I had a hard time believing that, honestly, that I was worthy of God's love. And through my walk with the Lord, since I've been following Him for a long time, but when I really wanted to go deeper in my relationship with the Lord, He really had to let me know that I was worth loving, that He gave His life to die for me. So any of the insecurities that I had or any of the shame, maybe from past mistakes that I had made, the Lord, I mean, He even reminded me this morning again how much He loves us, how much He loves me. And I think when we have that view of the Lord, how much He loves us, that He sent His Son to die, I'm just gonna say personally for me, for Wendy, that doesn't matter what I've done, that He still would have sent Jesus if it was just me living on this planet, then because I received that love for the Lord, it was easy for me to offer my heart back for Him. And so that's just, I don't know if anyone has ever struggled with feeling worthy of God's love, but if you ever have, know that you are worthy. You are so worthy of God's love. Not only did He send Jesus for you, but He created you. And with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind, your heart is the place that we gather hurts and can carry things that have affected us from our walk on this planet. And it's also where that we can give out the love for others. Our soul is our emotions and our will and our intellect and our consciousness and our mind. And you know, we have to renew our mind, and that's what's so great about this time of prayer and fasting. Not only are you renewing your heart and your soul, but just your mind and that crazy thinking that we can have sometime. So this scripture, love your Lord God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. It's a process. It's something that we walk out daily. That's why your morning devotional time or whenever you have your devotion is so important. It's kind of like every day we can reset. And what's so great about fasting as a body and at the beginning of the year, it's your reset for the year. Lord, what do you want me to accomplish this year? How do you want me to come up higher this year? So it's just so exciting. And then the questions here, how would you describe your relationship with God? For me, God is my Father. I call Him Daddy, Papa. It's just so amazing to know that no matter what happens, God is always right beside me. No matter what I face, I am never alone. And for me, that is huge, to know that I am not alone and how much God loves me. And even when I struggle and go through hard times, God is gonna turn that around and make it for good. And how do you love the Lord God with all your heart? It's just by, for me, being transparent and just longing for that intimate relationship and knowing that you can't earn it. It is a free gift that God loves us so much that He is here for us. And the other question is, what are your feelings towards God? It's so important how you view God, because that's gonna really, your image of God is gonna affect your relationship with Him. So just know that God loves you so much. He has a good plan for your life, and there's nothing that you and God cannot handle. I love that. And your mind, we already talked about that. It's so important for us to renew our mind, and the best way to renew our mind is through reading His Word and having that personal relationship with Him. So I hope this was a blessing to you. As always, after the devotional worship song is gonna follow, and that is, Lord, I give you my heart. So I hope you're doing well. I hope you are inspired for this second week in our prayer and fasting, and I'll be praying for you and believing for God to show Himself strong in your behalf, and that you will grow in a deeper walk, a more intimate walk with the Lord. I'm just gonna pray. Lord, I just thank you for this second week. I'm expecting amazing things in my life and in in my revelation of who you are, Lord. I just surrender and give you my mind, my heart, and my soul, Father. Just take it. It's yours, Lord. Let me come up higher in every area of my life, Lord. I want to be closer to you. I just thank you for this time that we have set apart to spend with you, Lord. And Father, give me the courage to face those areas that I need to face and know that with your strength that I can do anything that you've called me to do. Holy Spirit, have your way. Have your way in my life, my heart. Have your way in my mind and in my soul. And Father, I just thank you for your word, your rich word that will not return void. Father, we stand on your promises, Lord, and just grow deeper in our walk with you, Father. I give you my heart, I give you my soul. And as the song says, Lord, I live for you alone. Every breath that I take, every moment that I'm awake, Lord, have your way in me. So remember to keep journaling. And the question today is, what touched your heart today? And as always, I'm in prayer. Pray a prayer blessing over you. Psalm 129:8. The Lord's blessing be upon you. We bless you in the Lord's name. Love you guys.
This is my desire to honor.